In this video, I'll give you my overall verdict along with what I consider to be the main pros and cons of the Oral-B Water Flosser Advanced. Hey, it's John from Electric Teeth here. We assist you in selecting the right dental care products and understanding common dental healthcare topics. So I'm going to jump straight in and give you my overall verdict on the Advanced. Overall, I'm a little bit disappointed and had expected a bit better from Oral-B. As a market-leading brand, I would have expected a little bit better overall quality and performance, and I certainly expected it to be a little bit better value for money than some of the other products available on the market today. And unfortunately, it just doesn't stand out against some of the competition. And in fact, I do believe there are better value options available on the market today. So to see my most up-to-date recommendation on cordless water flossers, please do click the link in the description below, which will take you through to my cordless water flossers article, which we regularly keep updated. So then I'm going to move on to the main pros and cons of the Water Flosser Advanced. So the first and main pro has to be the fact that it's cordless. Now this might not be for everyone, but the fact is you've got more maneuverability with a cordless option. You're not tied to the wall for a power outlet or any form of hose to the large water tank. You can move around freely if you like. However, you are sort of tied to the bathroom because of the amount of water that gets pushed out from this water flosser. You are going to need to expel that into a sink. This actual unit has 150ml capacity in the water tank approximately, which gives you around about 45 seconds of flossing. Now, another benefit is the fact that it is rechargeable. By the very nature of a cordless unit, it has a built-in rechargeable battery, and this should give you around about 42 days of use on a single charge, assuming one use per day of a full flossing session of approximately 45 seconds. If you want to use it more regularly than that, by all means do so, but do expect the battery life to be affected as a result. So the third and final pro is the different water streams and intensities available on this unit. You've got different water flows available from the actual nozzle itself and the different intensities, so that gives you a good variety of cleaning options when it comes to flossing in between your teeth and along the gum line. So then moving on to the cons with the Oral-B Advanced, and unfortunately there are a few more cons than I would like to normally cover. So the first con has to be around the overall build quality. Now I've tested other variants of this Advanced water flosser and they've actually broken on me, most specifically the clip that holds in the water tank or reservoir on the bottom. Now that was through just regular hands-on testing, I was not being heavy-handed on it. Now I have to say in this particular unit it hasn't broken, but it certainly gave me cause for concern because Oral-B products are usually well built and I was surprised that the clip broke off so easily. It just doesn't also feel quite as good as it probably could. Now, it's not bad by any stretch of the imagination, but I think there are some better built products available on the market today. And yeah, I just had slightly higher expectations is, I suppose, where I'm getting at with this point. So another con then has to be the nozzle design and the rotation. With a lot of water flossers, you have the ability to actually rotate the nozzle up to 360 degrees. And you do have that here with the Advanced, but unfortunately, there's no way you're going to be able to do this whilst it's in the mouth. You require a lot of force to actually twist this. And I'm gripping this really quite hard now just to twist it as I demo it to you. So that's a little bit disappointing because a lot of others, you can actually rotate the nozzle whilst it's actually in the mouth. And also the design a bit here is a little bit different to most other water flossers. A lot of them have a nozzle or tip that comes out at about a 45 degree angle, whereas this is a 90 degree angle. So it's something to get used to and may not be quite as convenient for most people. Just something to bear in mind when you're kind of moving that around the mouth and trying to complete your flossing session. It might be different to something that you've previously used. Another con is a little bit the button placement. I'm not saying Oral-B have done a terrible job here, but there's three main buttons on this handle and you have to kind of remember which is which, and it's not always very easy to identify them when you're actually in use. They're all sort of a concave design and one's got a little raised ridge on it, but it would be nice if others had them so you could perhaps more easily identify which button is which when you've got it in hand, because when you're in hand and you're doing the flossing, you can't see this front panel and what you've selected. So it would be nice if there was just a little bit more feedback and way of understanding which buttons you've pressed rather than having to go by memory. So another con is around the modes and the different intensities. Now you've got three different intensities here. So you've got the intense, medium and sensitive, which is all well and good. Unfortunately, I couldn't tell a significant difference between each intensity. There was a difference, but I would have expected a more noticeable difference in terms of the actual pressure. it just didn't feel as significant as you would probably expect. And then on top of that, you've got the different controls for the on-demand and continuous flow and the different water flows from the actual tips that come provided as well. So there's a few different configurations in terms of the flow, but probably the key thing is the pressure difference didn't really vary all that much, and you don't get such a marked change between the intense and sensitive as most people would probably expect. So that's a little bit of a negative there in terms of the pressure settings aren't as variable as they are on some others. A point to note really in a small con is you get no travel case with the Oral-B Advanced. So if you do want to travel with this, you'll just need to pop it in your own bag or pop it loose. You'll probably want to take the nozzle out, but you don't get like a soft travel pouch that often comes provided with a lot of competing models. It does too come with quite a chunky charging stand. Now, yes, it needs to fit the base of the water flosser unit, so it's going to be quite large, but it's a little bit thicker and heavier than I would have anticipated. Now, you're not necessarily going to need to take that with you when you travel, but it might be something you want to take. But it's much heavier than I'd anticipated, and I didn't expect it to be as thick. Now, the offset to that is that it won't move around on a countertop all that easily because of that additional weight, but it's something to be aware of. And the last thing to be aware of is the price. I do think this is a little bit more expensive than it should be. The recommended retail price is $99.99, although typically you can pick it up for about $10 or so less. However, market leader Waterpik has one of their best cordless water flossers available for at least another $10 less than that. And bearing in mind that Waterpik are one of the market leaders with a lot of brand reputation and clinical studies behind them, I would have anticipated that Oral-B would have brought this in to be a little bit more price competitive with Waterpik, and I would have expected Waterpik to be the more expensive. But in actual fact, it's the Oral-B that is the more expensive option, and in my opinion, doesn't perform quite as well. So there we have it. That's my overall review, opinion, and pros and cons on the Oral-B Water Flosser Advanced. I do hope you found this video useful. If you did, be sure to give it a thumbs up. For more videos like this, click subscribe. But until next time, thanks for watching.